Hi, everyone. I'm Cameron Deatsch, Chief Revenue Officer at Atlassian. Welcome to the next set of the ITSM World Tour Customers Unplugged. In this set, we have the pleasure of welcoming our customers to the stage to share how Jira Service Management is unlocking high-velocity teams in their organizations. For our first session, please give a rock star welcome to Hamdam Bishop, Technology Operations Lead, and Danni Garcia, Technology Enablement Product Owner for Belong, Telstra's low-cost digital fighter brand. Thank you very much, Hamdam and Danni, for joining.
Thanks for having us.
Hi. Thank you.
I know you're both slammed and have a ton of work to do today, so really appreciate you taking the time for your peers and for your customers to share your story at Belong. But before we get down to all the details, I want to set the stage for our audience today. We'll give you a chance to introduce yourself in a minute, but given the nature of our events today as one big rock concert, I've got two questions for each of you. First, do you have a favorite musician or band? Danni.
Oh, man, this is a hard one. I'm going to go Queen because everyone can sing along to Queen and everyone knows it and it's fun. Yeah.
Can't go wrong there. Hamdam?
Look, is it really bad if I be honest and just say the Spice Girls?
Yes.
I could try and pretend to be cool, but I'm just going to be honest.
That's epic. Okay. And Danni, what was the first concert you ever attended?
First one was Beyonce, but this was like pre-Single Girls, like a long, long time ago. So yeah, it was fun.
Nice. Hamdam?
Mine was the Robbie Williams concert, actually, that Sneaky Sound System was a cover act for, and they were actually a good band too, so
nice.
I can change my answer to the previous question.
Okay, before we dive into Jira Service Management, can you tell us a little bit more about Belong as an organization?
Yeah, sure. Belong is Australia's first certified carbon neutral mobile and internet provider, launched by Telstra in 2013. And our purpose is all about making our world more inclusive, a more inclusive place by giving Australians the tools they need to reach across the planet at the touch of a button. And we really believe that mobile and internet services should be straightforward and shouldn't cost the earth.
So I understand that Belong, over the last couple of years, has gone through a pretty large digital transformation to, you know, completely change how you work and how you deliver value to your customers. But this has equally forced a change for how your IT operation teams have worked. Can you speak a little more to those changes within your organization?
Yeah, sure. So our broad changes in ways of working and improvement of our technology stack have involved lots of really great elements. And for us in technology operations, it's been about how we transform the way traditional IT ops is done into a much more modern, agile and DevOps mindset led way of working. So we've been working over the last couple of years to uplift our processes, to uplift our tools that we use, the technology that we use, and critically the way that we work, led by principles taken from site reliability engineering, bringing engineering led mindsets into operations and using that to really drive like highly reliable, highly available systems that serve our customers in the best way possible. And that's what we've been really focused on doing. And from a tooling perspective, transforming the way that we work as well.
Very cool. Thank you. Well, and Danni, this next question is for you. Can you tell us about how your role and how your day-to-day work fits into this broader kind of IT operations transformation initiative?
Yeah, sure. So I worked with technology operations for about 2 years as a process engineer. So that was all about continuously improving all of our ITSM processes. And some of these processes are like incidents, changes, problems, service requests, all of that kind of broad process work. So what I would do is I would just be looking for ways of automating it. I would also be looking at ways to document it and to communicate it with our teams as well to really embed those processes in Belong. So that was one of my main kind of responsibilities. But day to day for technology operations, you know, we're really just about keeping those critical systems as stable as possible for our customers. So we do that by looking into our monitoring, you know, looking at all of our alerting that we have in these systems, and just making sure that that experience is still there. We work a lot with frontline teams as well. And, you know, if there's any incident, then we will respond to that as well. So, yes, any one of those things can be in flight in the day to day for an ops person. So, yeah.
Well, obviously, no small amounts of change over the last couple of years within your technology teams and how you're working. Obviously, Jira Service Management, I believe, was part of this. Can you dive in a little bit of how and why did you choose Jira Service Management to help with your transformation?
Yeah, so we really started with how we work, our people and our processes, and we really thought about the people who were going to be using the tools. That was sort of the driving force of around our decision making. And when we assessed Jira Service Management, one of the things we were looking for, particularly in the IT service management space, and the fact that we were using this tool to support operations, we really wanted it to be easy for our people to use. At Belong, we have a model where the teams who build new features and products run those features and products in production. They're the custodians of those. So our teams are building features, they're busy delivering new products, but they're also supporting production at the same time. So we wanted the tools that they use to be really easy, intuitive, and integrated into their ways of working as well. So for us, when we looked at JSM, we already have other Atlassian tools in our development and engineering environment. And so it was a really logical choice in terms of ease of integration and use for our teams. And we really saw that it had the ability to be customized and tailored to the way we work, the processes we have, and therefore would be easy for us as an operations team as well to set up in the way that we need it to be used within the organization. And that was really important for us. We were people and process first, and then looking at what's the tool that will support and enhance and enable us to deliver on those processes.
Great. And Danni, did you have any, what was your role in that part of the process of choosing Jira Service Management? Were you kind of like the customer side of it, or were you also implementing it?
No, I was implementing it. Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah. I was part of the whole delivery process, rollout of this tool, which was a really big undertaking. I think we gave ourselves like 3 months or some insane milestone to, deliver this whole ITSM package. So that was, it was really exciting actually to be part of that, especially in an ops team, to have something that was so beneficial and just an instant improvement for all of us.
Oh, very cool. And then it sounds a lot as you start with the teams and how the teams individually work, and Danni, obviously culture comes into this pretty deeply. How do you make that connection between, say, a tool like Jira Service Management and how that reinforces the culture that you're trying to drive in your business?
So I think it really enforces the culture, as Hamdam's touched on, about DevOps and that kind of decentralized approach to operations, which is really important. And this is where all companies are progressing, right? We're going away from the traditional ops model where everyone comes to us for service requests or for incidences or for monitoring. And we're trying to empower the teams to really take ownership of the processes and of their operations, of their environments, whether that's in their development environments or whether that's a customer-facing environment. So for us, using something like Jira Service Management, that was just it was a great fit in our culture. It just naturally worked for us, and we've already seen massive improvements with that cultural uptake from frontline teams and from also technology teams.
No, that's fantastic. Obviously, we can talk about cultural fit and people being happy, but in the end, it comes down to, are we measuring anything? So on the operational side, I know you experienced some quantifiable improvements on your metrics. Can you speak to that, of how Jira Service Management, how you measure the impact?
Yeah, so I think one of our big measurements is the fact that, looking at our processes and looking at the really important processes like change management and incident management, these were the things that we really wanted to uplift and embed as well. And some of those metrics that we capture with those particular processes are really like mean time to acknowledge. So how fast does a delivery team or a development team take to actually pick up the ticket and look at it and respond to it? That's a super big metric for an ops team. So we saw just as like a really like massive improvement from last month, it was 57% of MTTA, mean time to acknowledge. And this month it's like 85%. So it's just absolutely like tracking in the right direction for us. And we put that down to the fact that, you know, Jira Service Management is such a simple tool to use. It's integrated so well with our systems as well. And so our teams are just uptaking those processes, and it just means it's better for our customers, you know, at the end of the day. So yeah, big metric.
Fantastic. I think a lot of this, you've also mentioned around driving, you know, more flexibility with your teams, but also I think a little more autonomy with your teams as well, like, you know, with a very decentralized operations model. Can you speak a little bit more to that? Just how, what does that actually mean in practice? Like, is there no governance and anyone kind of do whatever they want? Or like, how are you doing that, giving flexibility and autonomy, but also maintaining control?
Yeah, it's a great question, right? I think this is always the challenge in the balance of an operations team. It's like, how do we give a little but not too much? I think the main thing of autonomy, right, is, you know, in our perspective, it's really giving people access to the right data, the right operational data, so that they are in control and also in charge and feel that responsibility of the instances coming in, the changes coming in. They can see those tickets, they can see the queues coming in. It's all visual. So with Jira Service Management, you know, it's so easy for them just to create a dashboard and really monitor it and monitor those processes without coming to the operations team. And traditionally, people were just coming to us and being like, hey, can I get this, you know, dashboard created, which is good, but it's not really enabling them to do it. So now we've really changed, and all the teams have just created all their little monitoring and dashboards, and we just kind of look at it and we're just like, wow, that they've done it themselves. So I think that was a really great indicator that this is definitely being used well, and yeah, complete ownership. Yeah, for sure.
So obviously you've had some success. You're you know, still very much going through this journey and these new operational changes. But you know, what is next? What else do you plan to do? You plan to expand to Jira Service Management to more use cases, more departments?
Yeah, look, we're definitely looking at how we expand in terms of automation and orchestration tooling as well. So how do we use that to further enable the experience for our people in terms of how we engage during particularly incident scenarios. And we're using it broadly as well across the organisation from a service management perspective, and the use cases for that continue to grow. We've constantly got people knocking at our door saying, oh, hey, we've seen your tool and can you add these things for us too? So there's definitely interest across the organization to use it for different use cases, which is great. And for us, broadly within operations, our continuing strategy is to continue to build on automation, continue to build on preventative management of our production environments. And so we see JSM as a key part of that, and other tools that we can extend beyond there to assist us with, moving from reactive, which is where we were a couple of years ago, to very preventative management of our environments.
I also know many of these deployments, you know, we don't expect our customers or, you know, any organization to do everything by themselves. Did you have any help? Did you use an Atlassian partner or anyone to help with the actual implementation of Jira Service Management?
We did ask Accenture to come help us with the implementation. And we work as one team with our partners. So we had our operations team all in. So as well as all the day-to-day they were working on, people like Danni and others in the team were also managing and running this implementation. And we did have some help from some great people at Accenture as well.
Great to hear. Okay, well, the red light is blinking. I do believe that's all the time we have today. Hamdam and Danni, thank you so much for joining us to share more about your experience with Jira Service Management. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.